Hey everybody, welcome back to another Diecast Review. Race Craze here with a neat Diecast Review today. This one is going to be Bill Elliott's 2005 late model. Oh, I don't even remember the year. Let me take a look here. 2000 and... I want to say 2005. I'm not seeing anything though, so yeah, I'm kind of having to guess on this. I don't see... 2004. 2004 was the year. Okay, there we go. I was close. But anyway, yes, that'll be this late model. So here's the box, how these normally come packed. So let's dig into the box a little bit, because this is a different brand. This is not Action or Lionel. This is ADC, the American Diecast Company. They do a lot of dirt late models, dirt modifieds. I think they do a lot of sprint cars. They do a lot of the more dirt style racing. I don't know if they do anything else, really. I have to look in a little closer. Come on. There we go. So it's a sleeve and a pretty small box. I mean, honestly, it's a very nice, compact box. It's nice that they, you know, can get all these cars in here. I mean, granted, it is a shorter car, but, you know, I do like this nice... I mean, this is a sturdy box. This thing is strong. So I think the quality is pretty good out of them. There's a nice foam block on top, and then we got a lot of this inside because the guy I bought it from had tissue paper on everything, so... But, yeah, so that's the packing for those, and it's pretty good. And this is one of 3,500. There you can see it. So on to the late model itself. So I've never had a late model. This is the first late model I've ever done. So we're going to do the review of the late model chassis and then also of the late. I'll do a comparison video next time or later of a late model from... Lionel, really it was Action at the time, but one from Action and one from ADC, and we can look at the differences. So down the left side, we got these nice chrome rims here, dirt tires, very good detail on those. It all looks very accurate. Bill Elliott, awesome products. Number 9 there, and then we got our rear tire, again, all chromed out, looks very nice. We do have a front suspension, and we do have a rear suspension, very good quality there. The wheels do turn. They are posable wheels. They don't turn super far. They do catch the bumper. So I don't know if they can turn any farther than that anyway. Inside the seat, it's really hard to see, but there is some seatbelt detail. It's really hard to see in there because there's a lot of guards blocking it. We'll get to that one later. So on the back, there's our back bumper, our fuel cell underneath there with, you know, suspension and component pieces, all colored very well. There is also this little flap, and this is the gas can cover. So when you open that up, that's how you get your fuel filled for the race. And they don't do pit stops, so they won't need to flip that up any other time, really. We got our little, I honestly don't know if this was, it's a spoiler, but I don't know if it's cables or if this is how they hold it up and then angle it. Down the right side, same as the left, we've got our suspensions. Bill Elliott Awesome Products number 9. Suspension there. That comes out, and this comes out on both, and then it has Bill Elliott Awesome Products, and that's from the nose. So from the nose, looks like an Intrepid front end, 2004, so it would be about right. And then we got this air filter here, and the air filter looks great. The motor detail, fantastic. I mean, this is a really nice late model. They do a pretty solid job. Now, I don't know how expensive these are either. They might be a little on the expensive side, too. I know sprint cars generally are, and they are cool. I like sprint cars. I got 3 of those ready on the way. All the KKR diecasts. So Brad Sweet, Darren Pittman, and then Casey Kane's iRacing. So those are all on the way. But yeah, so we've got that. Now let's flip it over and look underneath. So there's the underneath side. We've got really good detail. Everything that's a piece is colored correctly or colored in some way. We got the ADC made in China down there. Really, this is pretty cool. This is a really cool diecast. As you look in here, it's really hard to see. Maybe I can get a better angle from somewhere else. Oh, there, I can kind of get an angle. Let's see. I'm going to have to do a little bit of light moving here. So bear with me during this short little pause of looking at the car. I want to try and make sure you guys can see because they do a top-notch job. So we're going to move this lamp. Angle that light down in there, and then we're gonna try and get that camera over there. There we go. So if I can get my phone out of the way, so you can actually see it. There's the steering wheel there. Does turn with the wheels. As I said, it's very difficult to see in there through a camera. It is easier to see through normally. The gauges, as I said, okay, so the gauges are numbered, printed on. There are seat belts in there. They look like they're extra, like they can move. They're felt in the plastic seat. So, again, the detail is very, very good on these. Go ahead and move my lamp back to where it needs to be. But, you know, they are not the cheapest things in the world either. So, yeah, I mean, I would recommend anyone who's a dirt fan or a fan of a driver who has a late model, just pick one of them up. They're super cool. So it's hard to say that it's not worth it because, you know, I mean, just having this neat, different type of car is cool. I really like having this one because of the difference. I mean, it's not a normal, you know, I've got like 15 Gen 6 Cup cars for the for certain drivers. It's like, you know, having some variety is pretty cool to have in a collection. But, yeah, so that's pretty much it for the late model. I'll show you the review or the comparison between them at some point. I do have a couple of action late models as well, and then a couple of these ADC modifieds. So hopefully I can get to those here in a short little bit. But anyway, this has been Race Craze. Leave a like on the video, comment, subscribe. Diecast giveaway on July 7th, so make sure you get subscribed by then to be eligible for that. It's a random draw, so that'll be at 7:30-ish, and I'll probably just post a video around 8 o'clock when I'm just going to record it, put it on the computer. I don't need to edit it or anything. So I'll just record it, put it up on the YouTube channel, and then I'll direct message the winner and find out who their favorite driver is and see what I can find for a good giveaway. So anyway, this has been Race Craze. Thank you for all your guys' support, and we will see you in the next video.